Hi there, this is Vivs here. In this video, I will show you how to use variables and constants in IntelliJ. We will try to store a value of 256 and see what happens. So first of all, I will just make my value equals to 256. Now, since this is not mathematics, we are getting an error. Notice that I have a semicolon at the end because this is a statement, and I get an error that says cannot resolve symbol my value. Java wants to know what is the data type of my value. Now the number is 256. It can be a byte or a short or an integer or a long. Let's try a byte first. I'll simply say byte space this. Notice that I immediately get an error and it says required byte found int and incompatible types here. Now the problem here is byte can store a number between -127 to 128. And 256 is certainly bigger than 128, which means there is not enough memory with the byte data type to store this number, because byte takes 1 byte or 8 bits. So let's take the other data type, which is short, and we don't see the error anymore. We can also use an integer, it's up to you, or we can use a long. But remember that we cannot use a boolean to store 256 because boolean can store only true or false. Now we could use a float to store this number, or we could use a double. And this works because float and double can store numbers with decimal points, which means they can also store numbers without them. Now let's say that we want to store your salary. We can simply say salary equals to say 12,200.5. Now notice that we have an error. First of all, we need to specify the data type and then we need to add a semicolon. Now I can try using an int, but it won't work because an integer cannot store a number with a decimal point. Notice the error. It says required integer found double. It was expecting you to put an integer value here, but instead it found a double. That's what that error means. So either you can remove the decimal point and say 12,200 and the compiler is fine with that, or you put the decimal point here and you get rid of the int and use a float instead. Now notice that we have an error. It says required float found double. Simple words, when you're making a float and when you're making a double in Java, there is actually no distinction between them. For example, I go and say double here, everything works perfectly. I go and say float here, how do you expect the compiler to decide whether this number is a float or a double? By default, a number such as this is called a literal. It is basically a value. This value is considered to be a double by default. You need to write an F over here, either in small or an F over here in capital, to indicate that this number should be considered as a floating point number or a float number, and then it works perfectly. Now there is a reason salary is called a variable. You can go later here and say salary equals to zero. Remember that the very first time you need to tell the Java compiler that the salary is of type float. After that, you can change the values any number of times you want without writing float at the beginning of each statement, because this is where you're creating it or declaring it, and this is where you're using it, and there's a difference between the two statements. Now this is a variable because the values can change, but what if this were a constant? In that case, I would go in the beginning and add this word called final, and notice immediately that I get an error. It says cannot assign a value to final variable salary. That means I cannot modify the value once I have created it. And what happens if I don't give a value? Let's take a look at that. I just write final float salary, and it says salary is never used. If you try to use it by printing this out, you will get an error saying that the salary variable might not have been initialized. Java expects you to give at least a zero value before you use the variable. So I could go here and say zero, and that would be perfectly fine. Now let's say I want to store a character, and I'll simply say my character equals to A. Immediately, we have an error. It says cannot resolve symbol my character, which simply means that there must be a variable whose data type you have not defined. And it says the same thing for symbol A. Now, Java compiler thinks that this is a variable, not a value. To indicate that this is a value, you must actually put this inside single quotes. And then Java compiler doesn't complain about that. At the same time, we make the data type here, which is char, and put a space. Similarly, we can change the value of my character to whatever you want every time now. Just add an equal to in between, and that is perfectly fine. However, if we make this final, then you cannot change the value. As you notice, the error is triggered here. Now let me show you a neat little trick that you can do with characters in Java. I could remove this A and I can simply write 65 over here. And notice that the compiler is not complaining anytime. But let's try printing this and say system.out.println, put your my character over there. Let's run the program at the top, click run hello world, and notice what gets printed here. It prints A here, even though the value is 65. Now this is because of the Unicode table that we were discussing in the earlier video. Characters are stored by converting them to numbers as per the Unicode table, and that is exactly what is happening here. 65 has a value of capital A if you check the ASCII table or the Unicode table, and that is what is getting printed out on the screen. Now let's remove this and add a single quote here and say A, and let's add another character B. Notice that we get another error. It says too many characters in character literal. There can only be one character inside single quote. It can be A, it can be space, it can be not, it can be any character that is out there on your keyboard. So hopefully you guys have understood variables, data types and constants in Java. As part of the Googleable section, be sure to type literals Java on Google and read about some of them from Stack Overflow and other relevant sites. In the meantime, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Have a nice day.